अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल। द हेवन एजुकेशन फाउंडेशन हैज अरेंज स्पेशल क्लासेस ऑफ पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच एंड टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज नाउन एंड इट्स काइंड्स। एंड डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब आवर चैनल। इन आवर अपकमिंग वीडियोस यू विल हैव नेक्स्ट वी हैव एज यू नो अबाउट पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच आर 18 नंबर्स एंड वी विल discuss in upcoming videos pronoun and its kinds and adjective and its kinds adverb and its kinds and other all 8 parts of speech we will discuss. And today our topic is noun and its kind. What is noun and why do we use parts of speech? First of all, we should know about what's significance and importance in our life about parts of speech. What are parts of speech? Parts of speech are words which we use in our daily lives. Without noun or naming word, how can you recognize yourself? And how can you demand of if you need something? If you will say, I need that, what is that? You can't demand something without naming word. Everything in a universe has name or naming word. For example, what is noun? Noun is the name of person, place or thing. And quality, state or idea. For example, Kasim, Lahore, pen, purity, rest, sadness, childhood, brotherhood. And proper noun. What is proper noun? Proper noun is the name of particular things or place individually. How? If you say, I like cities. Cities is common. If you will say, I like Lahore and Karachi, that would become your particular things. If you will say, what fruit do you need? I need fruits. Fruits would be your common noun. And when it would become proper noun? When you will say, I need apple. Then it would become proper noun. If you will say, boys. I need some boys to work. And then it would be your common noun. Even you will say, I need Aslam, Amjad and Amir to play. Or to play a game, then it would become your proper noun. And proper noun, name of a particular thing, person, place. And what is common noun? Common noun, which refers commonly to a large number of things of similar kinds. For example, boy, vegetables, fruits, etc. And what is the main difference between common and proper noun? When you will generally say about things boys, then it would be your common noun. Then you will say Aslam and Amjad, then it would become your proper noun. When you will say vegetables, I eat vegetables. It can be any vegetable. But when you will say I eat potatoes and tomatoes, it would become your, they both would become your proper noun. I would like to live in a cities. Cities, common noun. And you will say Lahore, Karachi, Islamabad. It would become your proper noun. And what is collective noun? Collective noun. Name given to a collection of a thing or group of people or animal. How? Army. Bunch of grapes. Herd of cattle. These are your collective noun. But you will use single word. Material noun or concrete noun. If you will say it is made of something. Material noun, a word used to name matter or substances not normally divisible. Gold, wool, water, and your all surrounding is replete with material noun. Whiteboard, scale, chair, table, wall, we can touch, we can lift, if you have chair, you can lift, book,
bag and man. All has material existence and it means they have material existence and it would become your material or concrete now. So next, what is our next material noun? Abstract noun. Abstract noun. Abstract noun is the name of state or feelings or emotions. Abstract noun, name given to ideas, feelings, characteristics, properties, etc., which have no material existence. They cannot be touched, but can be felt only. We can feel only. Bravery, sorrow, sadness, pleasure, love, beauty, pain, rest, etc. What is compound noun? Compound noun, two or more than two words joined together to form the name of one person or one thing. Matchbox, class fellows, playing area, workshop, playgroup, watchman. You can give by your own example. It is replaced with watchman, workshop, playing area, classmate, class fellows, etc. Countable noun. Definitely countable means which can be counted. That noun which can be counted by using digits. Number of table, number of chair we can count easily. Number of boys, number of school, number of students, number of trees, number of books we can count easily. Uncountable noun. Definitely we can't count. Names of materials, liquid substances which do not count. They don't have no plural form and don't take article before them. For example, water, wood, gold, number of stars, number of hair, number of grains of sands, etc. So you should subscribe my channel because you will have my upcoming videos, kinds, now upper parts of speech and their kinds. Noun and its kind we have done right this day, and we will in our upcoming video we will have my pronoun and its kinds. Thank you so much. Stay blessed. Allah Hafiz.